Hello and welcome to NewsClick. There is nothing that drives us more than standing in solidarity with the people's movements. Our teams are on the ground covering such movements extensively and hoping to bring out a change. In this segment, we bring you a roundup of various such movements that have happened over the past few weeks across country. On the 28th of June, hundreds of workers marched the streets of Delhi. Their grievances were directed at the non-fulfillment of promises on implementation of minimum wage and a stop to privatization and retrenchment. The workers are determined to fight for their rights and they have decided to hold a strike on the 20th of July.
17 workers mar gaye ek factory ke andar, bahar taala laga hua tha. Dusre din subah 7:30 baje main khud pahuncha tha wahan par. Humne wo waqia dekha. वर्करों को उठा उठा के तो रात को ही ले गए अस्पताल के अंदर गरीब हुई लाशों को ले गए.
There have been large scale protests in Tamil Nadu by its farmers. Issue being the Chennai Salem Green Corridor Express Highway project. Now this 10,000 crore rupee project is going to cut out 100 hectares of forest land, including 16 reserve forests. Even though the government statistics say that only 6,400 trees will be cut, a fact-finding team of All India People's Forum says that several lakhs of trees will be cut in the name of this corridor project, and this will adversely affect the livelihood of farmers and villagers of that area. The tribal communities in Karnataka have been protesting in large numbers, demanding for better rehabilitation. They have appealed to Chief Minister H.D. Kumaraswamy to announce a development package for welfare of forest-dwelling tribal communities. Now, this appeal was made in the hope that these communities would be included in the state budget, which is to say that adequate funds would be allocated to them. According to reports, the state government had previously released 200 crore rupees, but none of the money was utilized. On July 5, during a statewide bandh called by the opposition parties in Jharkhand, nearly 19,000 people were detained under preventive sections by the police. An amendment was made in the land bill by the government, which basically allows the state government to acquire land for certain projects like railways, irrigation, road, college, gas pipeline, without the social impact study. Now, the centre is accused by opposition parties for bringing in this amendment in favour of big industrialists and corporates rather than thinking about the common people. Huge public unrest was triggered when the president approved of the revised bill. Different political parties and mass organisations organised the statewide bandh on July 5. That's all for this week. To follow detailed reports on these protests and movements, please visit our website and our Facebook page. Thank you.